Father, we thank you for our Bible study. Thank you because we know you are present here with us. And we know that your presence will bring light, bring understanding. We pray, Lord, that you assist us in the teaching of today, that you will profit your people tonight in the study of Jesus' name. For us, those of us who are here, and for our brethren all over the city of Lagos and all over Nigeria and outside, all those listening at this time, we're praying, oh Lord, as you are mightily present with us here, you will be mightily present with everyone to you in Jesus' name.
Thank you very much. You can see that we're coming to
Revelation chapter 13, verse 11. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon, and he set all the power of the first beast before him, and causes the earth and they which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire to come down from heaven and on the earth in the sight of men, and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to that dwell on the earth, that they should make an image to which hath the lord by a sword and did live. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he causes all both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save that is except he that hath the mark or the name of the beast, number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that has understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. That is 666. 666. As we look at this passage, we are coming across a second beast. The first beast we have seen already in chapter 13, verse 1. Please look at your Bible. And I stood upon the sand of the sea, and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having seven heads and 10 horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, and upon his heads the name of blasphemy. This is during the period of the great tribulation, as the tyranny and the oppression of political power will reach their climax in the time of the great tribulation. So will the deception and the persecution of false religion. In this chapter you have two great leaders, that is leaders following after the devil, after Satan. On the one hand, the first beast coming up out of the sea, that is the Antichrist. On the second hand, the other hand, you have the beast coming out of the earth, that is identified as a false prophet, that is the great false prophet that will be part of the team of Satan and the Antichrist during the time of the great tribulation. And there will be great deception and persecution with false religion at that time. The Antichrist will be the political leader, while the false prophet, that is the beast rising up out of the earth, will be the religious leader. In what was studied already in chapter 13, verses 1 to 10, that is revealed unto us that you have the rise of the first beast, the Antichrist, out of the sea, that is, out of the raging tumultuous sea of chaotic humanity. This final tyrant, that is the Antichrist, will rise to rule over the whole world with the authority and the power of the dragon, that is, of the devil. The one we're studying today, second beast, he'll come out of the earth. That means there's a difference between the sea and the earth. There's a kind of stability on the earth, and there's a kind of solidity on the earth. Whereas on the sea there's chaos, and there are waves and there are storms. And this coming out of the earth, he'll come to take over the false religion that appeared settled on the face of the earth by the time of the great tribulation. This coming out of the earth is identified the false prophet. In Luke 16:13, you will see the activity of this, the false prophet, and you will see the things he does as he deceives the whole world. Chapter 16 of Revelation, verse 13. And I saw three unclean spirits like fire out of the mouth of the dragon, that is of the devil, and of the mouth of the beast, that is of the antichrist. Now out of the mouth of the false prophet, that is the second beast that we're studying about today. And then you read in chapter 19 verse 20. And the beast which was taken, and with false prophet that wrought miracles before him, with which he deceived them that had the mark of the beast, and worship this image. These both were cast alive into the lake of fire, burning with brimstone. That means then the final fate of that beast or the false prophet will be the same fate of the Antichrist. They'll be cast into the lake of fire. We're told in chapter 20 verse 10, and the devil which deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. That means as the three of them will be walking together, the devil, the Antichrist, and the false prophet, they too, they will suffer the same fate. At the end of that great tribulation, they will be cast into the lake of fire. And now we are told that this unholy trio will try to counterfeit the Holy Trinity. The dragon, that is Satan, is anti-God, opposed to God, blaspheming the name of God. We studied about him already in chapter 4 of Revelation, reading verse 3 and verse 4 to remind yourselves of the characteristics and the features of this dragon, of this Satan, the devil, that deceives the whole world. Look at Revelation chapter 12, reading verses 3 and 4, and there appeared another wonder in heaven. And behold, the great red dragon, having seven heads and ten horns, and seven crowns upon his heads, and he still drew the third part of the stars of heaven, and did cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman, which was ready to be delivered, for to devour a child as soon as it was born. And then you look at verse 9, which gives you a description and the details of this dragon. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. And he was cast out of the earth, out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Then we have the first beast, that is the Antichrist, the son of perdition. You see, the devil, the dragon, is anti-God, but the beast is Antichrist, that is opposed to the son of God, and is referred to as the son of perdition. If you look at 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, you will see what the Bible calls him there. In 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, looking at verses 3 and 4, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 3 and 4. Here we are told, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away false, and that man of sin, the son of perdition, that's the Antichrist, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he, as God, seateth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. We have the dragon, that's Satan, anti-God. And then you have the Antichrist, that is the beast, he is opposed to Christ. Now you have the third personality, that beast, he is anti-spirit, that is against and opposed to the Holy Spirit, and tries to counterfeit the work of the Holy Spirit. that were read already in chapter 13 of Revelation, verses 11 all through to 15. And this Satan, the master counterfeiter, it will be his grand purpose and plan will be to deceive all men. And the main function of the Holy Spirit, you know, is to direct praise to the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the case of this beast, this second beast coming out of the earth, that is the false prophet, it will be directing worship of the people to the Antichrist, who is the second person in the unholy trail. And so we understand that during the time of the great tribulation, we know that Satan will function a lot, and we also know that the beast, the first beast, will function a lot together with the one we're looking at today, which is the beast out of the very earth. And as we study all this, the Lord is preparing our hearts, telling us and showing us that the time of the great tribulation, it's going to be a terrible time, and it's going to be a very dangerous time, and the people that will be alive at that time, the suffering will be very much on them. As we look at the deception of this false prophet today, the topic of the title we're studying is the deceptive miracle working false prophet. A prophet, a false prophet, miracle working false prophet, but all it is with the intention and the purpose to deceive. The Holy Spirit directs us to all truth, whereas Satan tries to deceive so he can lead us into error. We're dividing the message to three parts today. Number one, description and the portrait of the false prophet. The description and portrait of the false prophet. Number two, deception through the power of the false prophet. The power that the false prophet will manifest will be to deceive. Deception through the power of the false prophet. Number three, the demand and persecution by the false prophet. It's going to be very terrible on the last days as the Antichrist will take the stage, and then the people that will not follow Satan, that will say they want to worship God, the persecution, the pain, the pressure will be so much upon them. Let's go step a step at a time. Number one, the description and the portrait of the false prophet. Please come back to Revelation chapter 13, reading from verse 11. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And he exercises all the power of the first beast before him, and causes the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly image, deadly wound, was healed. Here we learn about this beast, that he is the false prophet. As John continued the vision and was being shown and being told the things that were going to happen, here we learn that he said, I saw another beast. Another, but having the same evil intention. Another, but having the same evil power. Another, but serving the same devil. Another, preparing the devil, preparing the people for the devil to serve the devil, preparing to deceive the people. I saw another beast coming out of the earth. I need to remind you once again that all the things that will happen at the time of the great tribulation will not just happen suddenly. Because you see, the Antichrist, he will be a man. That's why it's referred to as the son of perdition. And by the time of the great tribulation, he will not be a baby. He would have been in the world, he would have been mixing with the people in the world. And to be a great political power, how will he be a great political power if he had been known and not be involved in politics before the time of the rapture? Because when the rapture takes place, the great tribulation will begin immediately. And because the great tribulation will begin immediately, and the Antichrist taking over the son of perdition will not be a baby, you understand, then he must have been alive at the time when the church was still here. But then the presence of the church and the power of the Holy Spirit will be restraining the great activities of that Antichrist. And the same thing you find concerning the false prophet, that the false prophet will not be a person that will be a baby in religion. He will not be an infant. He will be somebody that already grown up and would have been here during the time of the church. And the Bible says there will be a falling away force, which means that the false prophet will have been preaching. There will be some false prophets rallying around this climax or the epitome of the greatest of the false prophets, when he will eventually come out. and the personal attributes are ascribed to this beast, because it talks about, number one, that beast speaking, number two, exercising power, number three, influencing people, number four, doing great things, wonders, miracles among the people to deceive the people, number five, deceiving them that dwell upon the face of the earth. Look at verse 11 and see the description of this beast. It says, and I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. Well, see, this is exactly what Jesus Christ said when he was still here on earth, on the Sermon on the Mount, that the false prophets will be like their sheep's clothing, sheep's appearance, but then inwardly, internally, they will be like ravening wolves. If you look at Matthew chapter 7, reading from verse 15, it says, beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. You will find that false prophets are always the same on the exterior, on the outside. They look like a lamb, but they will have on the inside the nature of the dragon, the voice of the dragon, the characteristics of the dragon, the attributes of the dragon. And it is to deceive the world. He will put on a pleasing personality or the calmness of a lamb, but in reality, the nature and the wickedness of Satan, that is, of the dragon, the false prophet, like all false prophets before him, will be a great deceiver, looking like a lamb. And there will be some gentleness around him. There will be some softness about him that is deceptive, deceiving. Let us take note that he has two horns. How about the real lamb of God? You see, when the devil tries to counterfeit what the Lord Jesus is doing, if you're very, very observant, you'll be able to detect the counterfeit. You'll be able to detect how fake the false one is. Let's come back to Revelation 13 verse 11 again. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb. As we think of this false lamb, and then we think of the real lamb, the Lamb of God, how many horns does the Lamb of God really is depicted to have? Look at Revelation chapter 5, reading verse 6. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb, as each had been slain, having how many horns? Tell me out loud. Seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent forth into all the earth. The real Lamb of God has seven horns, and that seven is a number for perfection. It's a number for totality. It's a number for completeness. All power on earth and in heaven is given unto me, the Lord Jesus Christ said. And as Jesus said that, he showed that he has all authority and all power. Not only that, he has all knowledge, because that's why it says, having seven eyes. And those seven eyes are the seven meaning completeness of the power, illumination, and enlightenment, and knowledge, and insight of the Holy Spirit within him. As you come back to Revelation chapter 13, and you're looking at verse 11, and it says, I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and spake as a dragon. Actually, the nature within is the nature of the dragon. And this is what the devil does, and with the false prophets that appear today, that is the false prophets that will be there, even at the time before the church goes away, before the church is raptured, because as I told you before, that the Antichrist and the events of the Great Tribulation will cast their shadows before them, that some of these things will be happening in miniature form, moderate form, in some size, in some shape, before the time of the Great Tribulation. It is at the time of the Great Tribulation, everything will really blow out without any limit and without any control. Now, at this time now, let us see what the false prophets try to do. How they try to camouflage, how they try to show us if they are for real. In 2 Corinthians chapter 11, I'm reading from verse 13, 2 Corinthians chapter 11, reading from verse 13. For such are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. They will call themselves apostles, They call themselves prophets, or maybe evangelists, or maybe pastors and teachers, or maybe they call themselves great, great leaders. But it says that they transform themselves into the apostles of Christ. And then we're told in verse 14, and no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. When Satan wants to deceive, he doesn't come as a demon, he doesn't come as a dragon, he doesn't come as the old serpent, he comes as if he were an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as ministers of righteousness, whose heir shall be according to their works. That's the reason we need to take care today, we need to be watchful today, because of the things that the Antichrist will do, and because of what the false prophets will do. And the false prophets of today, they are there to deceive. And that is the reason.